हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ प्रोफेसर पी वी शिंदे, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सॉइल साइंस एंड एग्रीकल्चरल केमिस्ट्री फ्रॉम केकेवा कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर, नासिक. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर द लेक्चर ऑन यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ सलाइन एंड सीवेज वाटर फॉर इरिगेशन पर्पज. फ्रेंड्स, दिस वीडियो इज ओनली फॉर एजुकेशनल पर्पज, नॉट फॉर कमर्शियल यूज. बिफोर स्टार्टिंग the utilization of saline water and sewage water for irrigation purpose, it is important to see what do mean by saline water. Saline water contains high concentration of dissolved salt. Mainly that dissolved salt is sodium chloride. There are different factors which are responsible for formation of saline water, like wastewater and brine discharge from different industries, road salts, salt deposits, marine deposits. High evaporation and low precipitation cause the formation of saline salts. Inadequate drainage and intensive irrigation causing rising water table, and that's why saline water is formed. Here we can see the changes to the distribution of salt in the landscape due to the change in land use pattern. Here this picture shows before clearing, that is the system is in balance, most water is used where it falls. Next photograph or picture show after clearing and irrigation, evaporation and irrigation seepage concentrates saline groundwater at the surface, and later and last stage, that is because of the clearing of vegetation, protective plants cover is killed by the accumulation of salt at the surface, the land is open to erosion. That's why due to the clearing of land surface, there is the accumulation of saline water. Let us see how saline water is utilized for irrigation purpose. There are different management practices for the safe use of saline water for irrigation, primarily consist of selection of crops or crop varieties that will produce satisfactory yields under the existing or predicted condition of salinity or sodicity. Special planting procedures that minimize or compensate for salt accumulation in the vicinity of the seed. Irrigation to maintain a relatively high level of soil moisture and to achieve periodic leaching of the soil. That's why that soil becomes neutral. Use of land preparation to increase the uniformity of water distribution and infiltration, leaching and removal of salinity. Special treatment, that means such as practices like tillage, addition of chemical amendments, addition of organic matter and growing green manure crops, that are also useful for management of saline water that is used to maintain soil permeability and soil tilth. The crop grown, the quality of water used for irrigation, the rainfall pattern and climate, and the soil properties determine to a large degree the kind and extent of management practices needed. This photograph indicates pattern of salt buildup as a function of seed placement, bed shape and level of soil salinity. That means formation of that salt is depend on seed placement, bed shape and level of soil salinity, which manage seedbed and grading fields to minimize local accumulation of salinity. There are different types of cultivation, single row bed, double row bed and sloping. There is the formation of or percentage of formation of salt in that particular type of bed. This picture shows the effect of irrigation system on the soil salinity pattern and yield of bell pepper at two levels of irrigation water quality. Here yield kg per hectare, and this indicates the yield kg per hectare, saline soil and low salinity. In low salinity, the growth of pepper crop is good as compared to saline crop due to the accumulation of high amount of salinity. It is important to know how manage soil under saline water for irrigation purpose. There are different physical, chemical and biological soil management measures which helps to facilitate the safe use of saline water in crop production, like tillage. Tillage is a mechanical operation that is usually carried out for seedbed preparation, soil permeability improvement, to break up surface crust and to improve water infiltration. If tillage is improperly executed, it might form a plow layer or bring a salty layer closer to the surface. Sodic soil are especially subject to puddling and crusting. They should be tilled carefully and wet soil condition avoided. Heavy machinery traffic should also be avoided. Due to of heavy machinery, there is a compactness form in soil structure. More frequent irrigation, especially during the germination and seedling stages, tends to soften surface crust on sodic soils and encourages better stands. Second important parameter or management practice, that is deep plowing. Deep plowing refers to the depth of plowing from about 40 to 150 centimeter. It is most beneficial on stratified soils, that is layered soil having impermeable layers lying between permeable layers. In sodic soils, deep plowing should be carried out after removing and reclaiming the sodicity. Otherwise, it will cause complete disturbances and collapse of the soil structure. Deep plowing to 60 cm loosen the aggregates, improve the physical conditions of these layers, increase soil water storage capacity and helps control salt accumulation when using saline water for irrigation. Crop yield can be markedly improved by plowing to this depth every 3 or 4 years. The selection of the right plow types, that is shape and spacing between shanks, sequences, plowing depth and moisture content at the time of plowing should provide good soil tilt and improve soil structure. Sanding. Sanding is used in some cases to make a fine texture surface soil more permeable by mixing sand into it. Thus, the relatively permanent changes in surface soil texture is obtained. When properly done, sanding results in improved root penetration and better air and water permeability, which facilitate leaching by saline sodic water, and when surface infiltration limits water penetration. The method can be combined with initial deep plowing. That means this sanding method is combined with the initial deep plowing. It is more advantageous. Third important management practice, that is chemical amendments. Chemical amendments are used to neutralize soil reaction, to react with calcium carbonate and to replace exchangeable sodium by calcium. This decreases the ESP, that is exchangeable sodium percentage, and should be followed by leaching for removal of salts derived from the reaction of the amendments with sodic soil. They also decrease the sodium absorption ratio of irrigation water if added in the irrigation system. Gypsum is by far the most common amendment for sodic soil reclamation, particularly when using saline water with the high sodium absorption ratio value for irrigation. Calcium chloride is highly soluble and would be satisfactory amendment, especially when added to a irrigation water. Lime is not an effective amendment for improving sodic condition when used alone, but when combined with a large amount of organic manure, it has a beneficial effect. Next point, that is use of sulfur. It is too effective. It is inherent until it is oxidized to sulfuric acid by soil microorganism. Other sulfur containing amendments like sulfuric acid, iron sulfate, aluminium sulfate are similarly effective because of the sulfuric acid originally present or perform upon microbial oxidation or hydrolysis. Fourth soil management practice, that is use of mineral fertilizer. Timing and placement of mineral fertilizer are important, and unless properly applied, they may contribute 2 or cause a salinity problem. Next, management practice, that is use of organic manures and mulching. Incorporating organic matter into soil has a two principal beneficial effect of soil irrigated with saline water with high sodium absorption ratio and on saline sodic soils. Improvement of soil permeability and release of carbon dioxide can certain organic acids during decomposition. This will help in lowering soil pH, releasing calcium by solubilization of calcium carbonate and other minerals, thereby increasing electrical conductivity and replacement of exchangeable sodium by calcium and magnesium, which lowers the exchangeable sodium percentage. Growing of leguminous and using green manure will improve soil structure. Green manure has a similar effect to organic manure. Here, during the decomposition, different organic acids are formed, and that's why due to their organic acids, the salinity or raised pH is decreased, and hence there is lowering of pH. Next point, that is salinization. During fallowing may be severe where a shallow water table exists, since evaporation rates of about 8.3 and 1 mm per day could occur from the dry surface of the fine sandy loam when the water table is kept at 90, 120 and 180 cm from the soil surface respectively. Mulching to the reduced evaporation losses will also decrease the opportunity for soil salinization. When using the saline water where the concentration of soluble salts in the soil is expected to be high in the surface, mulching can considerably help leach salts, reduce ESP and thus facilitate the production of tolerant crops. Thus, whenever feasible, mulching to reduce the upward flux of soluble salts should be encouraged. It is all about the management practices for using the saline water for irrigation purpose. Next important point, or we can say topic, that is utilization of sewage water in agriculture, or we can say use for irrigation purpose. Let us see what is sewage water. Sewage water is waste water from people living in a community containing mainly household sewage plus some industrial waste water. This picture show the sewage water. It is important to know the causes of sewage water or how sewage water form. There are different factors due to sewage water form, like the use of toilet as a bins, cooking fats, overcapacity of wastewater, flooding, improper handling of wastewater, root infiltration. Let us see what are the advantages of sewage water used for irrigation purpose. Like, use of sewage water for irrigation not only improves the growth rate of plant but also reduces the cost of chemical fertilizer. Here, by using the sewage water, there is cost minimized due to the it improves the growth rate of plant by supplying the different nutrients after the treatment. The application of wastewater to cropland and forest is a smart option for disposal because it can be improve the physical properties and nutrient content in soil. Wastewater can often contain substantial concentration of organic and inorganic nutrients, for example nitrogen, phosphate, which are crucial for crop growth. The soil microorganisms have been observed to have an increased metabolic activity when sewage effluent is reused in irrigation. Beneficial effect of sewage irrigation on the total chlorophyll and carotenoid content of the maize plant. They also recorded increased nutrient content in plant and soil. In short, after the treatment or by giving different treatment to sewage water, it can be safely used for irrigation purpose for improving soil physical, chemical and biological properties. This photograph shows the use of sewage water for irrigation has many or different applications, like it can be used in crop irrigation, aquaculture, source of nutrients. It is a source of PGPR, also the source of enhanced plant growth, preserving water reservoirs, saving money. And last point, that is saving money, is very important, and that's why the use of sewage water is good for irrigation purpose, but after the treatment. There are different treatments for sewage water. For example, there are use of aquatic plants such as water velvet or duckweed for the removal of contaminants from the sewage water. This picture shows when sewage water used in aquatic plant such as water velvet or duckweed, it acts as a heavy metals accumulate. That means that plants accumulate heavy metals in their body, and remaining water is called as treated water. It is reused for irrigation purpose. That water is free from different heavy material or heavy metals or polluted materials. These photographs also show the biological treatment of wastewater for use in agriculture. In first step, there is a septic tank. In that septic tank, household material comes in that tank. After that, settling and anaerobic digestion finally filter to retain solids, and that material comes to treatment wetland. Here, lined gravel and bed 50 to 80 cm deep, diverse plants for root penetration, control box with standpipe. And in step 3, that is treated water which comes from the control box. Here, subsoil irrigations or conventional leach drain, landscape or harvestable plants. It is not used for crops or leafy vegetables. But like this biological treatment, the wastewater we can reuse in agriculture. Second treatment, that is natural ecological treatments. Here, the contaminants or plants remove the contaminants from sewage water by following methods like phytoextraction. Here, plants remove heavy metals and other pollutants from the water and soil as a well as groundwater and concentrate them into their harvestable parts. Then phytodegradation. Here, in phytodegradation process, the pollutants present in contaminated water are degraded by plants and associated microbes. Plant roots, in conjunction with their rhizosphere, microorganisms are utilized to remediate soils irrigated with sewage water. Next, that is phytostabilization. Here, the plants stop the mobility of the pollutant which is present in sewage water. Then next one is the phytovolatilization. Plants also volatilize the pollutants present in sewage water. Next, rhizofiltration. It is the removal of pollutants from the contaminated water by accumulation into plant biomass. Third treatment, that is engineered treatment or engineered approaches, like oxidation pond. Oxidation ponds are used for reducing the biochemical oxygen demand, that is BOD, of wastewater. This is very effective and simple technology which consists of ring-shaped channel equipped with mechanical aeration devices. The wastewater is screened and aerated through the devices, which circulates at 0.25 to 0.35 meter per second. Next method, that is aerobic ponds. In aerobic treatment of wastewater, bacteria and algae are used that maintain aerobic condition throughout its depth. The aerobic ponds may be shallow or aerated. Third method, that is anaerobic pond. It is biological treatment of wastewater in which naturally occurring bacteria are utilized for breaking the biodegradable compounds present in wastewater. These bacteria under anaerobic condition may remove high concentrations of biological oxygen demand and chemical oxygen demand. The presence of anaerobic bacteria in these ponds break the organic matter present in the effluents and thus release methane and carbon dioxide, whereby sludge is deposited at the bottom while crust is formed on the surface. Next, activated sludge system. It is very important method, that is activated sludge system. This is a biological wastewater treatment which is mainly used for removal of biodegradable compounds and pathogens present in wastewater. Its efficiency depends on retention time, temperature, pH and the presence of other biological flora present in wastewater. And last method, that is trickling filter. This technique is used to remove or reduce the pathogen and level of nitrogen in the wastewater, as a pathogens present in wastewater may cause serious threats to humans, mostly in developing countries of the world. This trickling filter is composed of some porous material like rock, sludge or plastic medium having large surface area and permeability. The microorganism in the wastewater gets attached with the filter media. Thank you.